Hello friends, in this video we are going to see asynchronous up down counter. Actually, in the previous video we have seen separately what is asynchronous up counter and asynchronous down counter. In this video we are going to club both the feature in the same circuit. And how to achieve this? Let us see. So let us start with asynchronous up down counter. As we have already seen, for example, if I want to have an asynchronous counter, the basic thing that we have seen is that we have to use whatever flip-flop but should be in toggle mode. Just to understand, let me take this as T1 and T2, meaning that they are toggle flip-flop. Let me say both of them are connected to 1. So the primary condition that whatever flip-flop that is used in asynchronous counter should be configured into toggle mode is satisfied, because you know that when T flip-flop, when T is tied to 1, it enters into a toggle state, isn't it? So the type of triggering that I'm going to use over here is a negative edge triggering. So at every negative edge, as you know that this flip-flop keeps on toggling its output, that is what we called as Q1, will get toggled from 0 to 1, then 1 to 0, and this goes on at every negative edges of the clock input applied, isn't it? Also, you all are aware, as we have discussed in the previous lecture, that is, suppose the output Q is connected as a negative edge as a clock input to the next flip-flop, then it enters into asynchronous up counter. So for counter to work as up counter, this kind of clock should be given. Or else if I want this to work in a down mode, what I need to do is, suppose if I still assume the type of clock to be a negative edge triggering only, then it becomes mandatory to provide this clock not from Q but from Q bar. So this is something that we have already seen in the last lecture, so I'm not going into detail of this. I'm sure you have watched all the videos serially because this is necessary. So if Q is applied as a clock, it acts as up counter. If Q bar is applied as a clock to the next flip-flop, it acts as a down counter, provided in both the cases the type of clock used is a negative edge triggering. For that, we are going to form a simple circuit, meaning that we are going to form a same circuit which we can configure into up counter as well as a down counter. For that, let me just show you on a smaller scale, and then in the next slide we will actually see the actual 3-bit asynchronous up down counter. So over here, what I'm doing is I'm using the simple hardware which consists of 2 AND gates and 1 OR gate over here. This OR gate output is going to act as a clock in negative edge. So output of these 2 AND gates, as you can see, it is getting clubbed and they are acting as input of the OR gate. What I'm actually going to do, I'm going to use the both outputs, that is Q1 as well as Q1 bar. Let me apply Q1 bar here, let me apply Q1 here. We know that we actually have to apply the clock to the flip-flop number 2 either from Q1 or from Q1 bar. We don't apply both at a time, I'm sure you know that. And in order to achieve that, what I'm actually going to do, I'm going to use a control input, which, let's say, I'm connecting as it is here, and here I'm going to connect it with the help of bubble. I hope you understood that. Now let's see what is going to happen. Please pay attention. Don't forget these two configurations. In configuration number 1, if Q is applied as a clock, it is going to act as an up counter. And in the second configuration, if Q bar is applied as a clock, then it acts as a down counter. So here, let me first of all make that control equal to 1. This control is actually going to control the configuration of this counter. If control is equal to 1, it will act as an up counter, and when this control input is equal to 0, it will act as a down counter. And how it is achieved? Please pay attention. Let us assume control equal to 1. So what happens when control is equal to 1? Try to understand. When control is equal to 1, here as you can see, there is a presence of bubble. So what is actually, even though you have applied 1, what goes inside is 0. I hope you understand that. And in case of AND gate, I'm sure you know that when one of the input is equal to 0, output is by default 0 because AND gate gives you product. So please don't forget, the another input of this AND gate is Q1 bar. So Q1 bar into 0 becomes 0. Here, Q1 gets multiplied with Q, or I would say there is a product of Q and 1 together. So output is Q. Then the job of OR gate is to take a sum of these two inputs. So first input, as you can see, Q, the other input is 0. Of course, the output is Q. As you can see, ultimately, what is applied on the clock? What is applied on the clock? So applied on the clock is Q, and therefore I would say it is getting resultant into a very first configuration that I'm highlighting, and therefore it acts as an up counter. I hope you understand that. Let me assume the next case where I'm not going to apply control equal to 1, I'm going to keep control equal to 0. So what is going to happen over here? One of the input is 0, and therefore let me just name this as AND gate number 1 and AND gate number 2. So what is going to happen is AND gate number 1 gets disabled. Disabled in the sense, even though you apply 1 or 0 over here, since one of the input is equal to 0, output is equal to 0. So output that I'm going to get over here is 0. Whereas, even though you have applied control value equal to 0, but because of this bubble, what gets inside is not 0, but what you really get is 1. This 1 gets multiplied with Q1 bar, or I would say Q1 bar into 1 is Q1 bar. As you can see, now we have an OR gate where one input is 0, the other input is Q1 bar. Of course, the sum is Q1 bar. As you can see, what is applied ultimately over here is Q1 bar or Q bar, isn't it? Which gets resultant into the second configuration, isn't it? And in the second configuration, as you can clearly see, it acts as a down counter. This is how, by using the extra hardware, you can make a provision to apply Q as clock input or Q bar as the clock input, depending upon what you apply on a control input. I hope you understand that. So as I have promised that once you have understood how we are going to use this control input, I'm going to actually show you the 3-bit asynchronous up down counter. Let's see. So as you can see, it is a 3-bit asynchronous up down counter. Of course, it is called as 3-bit because 3 flip-flops are used over here, right? So observe this. T1 is connected to 1. T2 is connected to 1, T3 is connected to 1. So all the flip-flops are working under toggle mode, and this is the primary eligibility to act as asynchronous counter. Also, as you can see, the same hardware I have used twice over here between every two flip-flops. The main clock is given to the first flip-flop, and you know that the very first flip-flop by default acts as LSB. So I have applied a clock here. The type of triggering that we are using is negative age, isn't it? So what is going to happen? Let us see. Over here, this is actually a control input. When this up slash down bar value is equal to 1, it is going to act as up counter. And when this value becomes 0, it is going to act as a down counter. Now this can be understood very easily. Let us understand case number 1. In case number 1, when UP slash DN bar control input is set to 1, you know that the desired operation over here is up counter, but let's see how it is going to happen. When up slash down bar is equal to 1, as you can see, this upper line becomes 1. So this becomes 1. since this line is equal to 1, so this also becomes 1. Don't forget there is a presence of inverter over here, which makes the lower line equal to 0. So what is available on upper line of a control input? 1. And what is available on the lower line of control input? 0. Now pay attention over here. As you can see, there is a connection from the lower line. So what is applied on the second AND gate input is 0. Similarly, there is a connection over here also. So since on the lower line there is 0, what gets applied at the input of AND gate number 4 is also 0. Let us see what are the other inputs of AND gates. So I'm talking about the first AND gate. As you can see, it is Qn over here. What we have for the another input of second AND gate is Qn bar. Next over here, it is Qn here and Qn bar here. So you know the fact that when one of the input becomes 0, by default the other output is 0, or I would say output of the AND gate is equal to 0. AND gate gets disabled over here. And since over here also one of the input is equal to 0, output is by default 0. Please remember that in AND gate, if one of the input is fixed to 0, it gets disabled irrespective of what you have applied on the second input. Output is by default 0. Over here, for AND gate number 1, I'm talking about, AND gate gives you product. So product of Qn with 1 is obviously Qn. So output is Qn. As you can see, Qn is applied as a clock input to the next. Definitely, that is what we require in up counter, isn't it? Over here, that is, you know, I'm talking about this, output is also Qn. Now, this OR gate gives you sum of Qn and 0. Obviously, the output is Qn. As you can see clearly, Qn is applied as a clock to the next, and therefore it acts as a up counter. I hope you understood this. Let us understand the second configuration, that is down counter. So let us understand what happens when up slash down bar control line equal to 0. We are expecting it should act as a down counter. Let us see. The moment this is equal to 0, the upper line remains 0, but lower line, because of the NOT gate, remains 1. Then just check out, we have a connection from here. One of the input is 0. We have also connection over here. This input is 0. When one of the input of any AND gate is 0, that respective AND gate, that is AND gate number 1, AND gate number 3, gets disabled. By default, we have 0 output here. Similarly, we have a connection from here, but since the lower control line is set to 1, this is 1. The other input is Qn bar. Qn bar into 1 is Qn bar. Therefore, the sum of Qn bar and 0 is Qn bar. As you can see clearly, Qn bar is acting as a clock. Over here, that is the second stage. The connection is from here. One of the input is connected to 1. The other input is set to Qn bar. Qn bar and 1 gives you product as Qn bar. Then Qn bar, when you take sum with 0, obviously you get Qn bar. You can clearly see that Qn bar is acting as a clock. So you know the fact, when Qn is applied as a negative edge clock, it acts as a up counter. When Qn bar is acting as a negative edge clock input to the next stage, it acts as a down counter. I hope you understood this schematic. Thank you.